Hello friends, good morning. Welcome to our chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss about inductive cleavage in mass spectrometry. Okay, let us start. See, inductive cleavage. In mass spectrometry, inductive cleavage can be acknowledged in the compounds which has hetero atom flanked between two carbon atoms. Means this inductive cleavage can be observed in the compounds. So the compounds which are having the hetero atom, so that compound should have hetero atom, and that hetero atom should be flanked, means should be present, that hetero atom should be present between two carbon atoms. So in this case, inductive cleavage can be observed. Okay, next, see, if an electron pair is completely transferred towards a center of positive charge, see here, electron pair means bond. We know that in a single bond, two electrons are present. So, we can call it as electron pair. So, if an electron pair is completely transferred to the center of positive charge, what will happen means, as a result of this inductive effect, means this effect can be shown by conventional arrows. So, normal arrows. Then, ion will fragment by inductive cleavage. Okay, see. If an electron pair is completely transferred towards atom having the positive charge, means then that can be schematically shown by using conventional arrows. Okay, then that ion will fragment by inductive cleavage. Okay, next, see, this inductive cleavage means this effect can be observed in ethers, amines, means that is hetero atom connected to carbon atoms. See, if we observe the ether means ROR. So here oxygen is the hetero atom. See, that hetero atom is flanked in between two alkyl groups. Means here this hetero atom is connected to two carbon atoms. So this inductive effect can be observed in ethers, amines, that is hetero atom connected to carbon atoms. Okay, next. See, here along with inductive effect, heterolytic cleavage is seen. So here inductive effect and heterolytic cleavage is seen. Okay, next, this inductive cleavage can occur both at radical sites as well as cationic sites also. Okay, inductive cleavage can occur both at radical sites and cationic sites. Okay, next, see, let us observe this examples. See, here I have taken three examples. I am going to explain these two examples. Okay, right now. Okay, see, this means the resonance form of this is this one. Okay, let us observe the inductive cleavage in this. See, here at this carbon atom, positive charge is present. See, already on this oxygen atom, single radical is present. So, from this carbon atom, here single electron is donated to oxygen. So, that this single radical along with this radical, here double bond formation occurs. See, observe here. Oxygen, double bond, and R. Okay, see, and as here the electron is donating from this side, here the alkyl group gets positive charge. Okay, next, let us observe this example. See, here also the same thing. See, here from this bond, see, here the complete, here only a single radical is donating, so that here we have used half arrow. But here the electron pair means entire bond is gonna break. So, see, here from this R means the bond present between R and oxygen is gonna break. So, that here the R get positive charge. So, ET means here we may use ethyl or methyl like that. Okay. Here the R get positive charge. And here it is as usual, friends. Means, see, this positive charge is going because here the bond is breaking, so that here only a single radical is going to present. Okay, friends, I hope you understood. Thank you.